Now to America, remembering the life of former Secretary of State Colin Powell, who died from complications of COVID-19. Powell was fully vaccinated, but he was also diagnosed with multiple myeloma, which suppresses the body's immune response. Powell's legacy runs deep into the military as well, heading up the Joint Chiefs of Staff during Operation Desert Storm. His trailblazing career didn't end there. 10 on Your Side's Chris Horn now with more on Colin Powell's death and some of his local connections over the years. Chris?
Yeah, Tom, Powell broke barriers for African Americans who sought the highest levels of public and military service. He held the top uniformed post in the Pentagon, was the country's chief diplomat, advised several presidents, and ran for the office himself. President Biden said Powell embodied the highest ideals of both warrior and diplomat and was someone who believed in the promise of America because he lived it. Senator Mark Warner says Powell was a patriot and public servant. Congressman Bobby Scott says Powell exemplified the temperament and leadership that should be the model for all Americans. As the first African-American chairman of the Joint Chiefs, Powell addressed the crew of the battleship USS Wisconsin. That was during Operation Desert Shield. It was the year before the Wisconsin was decommissioned for a final time and eventually made its way to Nauticus in Norfolk as a floating museum. Vice President Kamala Harris described what an inspiration and role model Powell has been in his 84 years.
Young service members and others, not only in the military, but in our nation and around the globe, took notice of what his accomplishments meant as a reflection of who we are as a nation. And I think that's one of the most important things to take away.
Flags have been lowered at the White House and the State Department as a tribute to Powell. Coming up at 6:30, NBC Nightly News will have more on his life and career. Chris Horn, 10 on Your Side.
All right, a giant among public figures. Thank you, Chris. And now